The objective for this video is to learn how to construct a histogram using the TI graphing calculator. In a previous series of videos, we used the data for the number of United States Electoral College members allocated to each state as of the 2016 U.S. presidential election in order to learn how to construct a grouped frequency distribution and then a histogram. We can use the TI graphing calculator to construct this histogram for us. In order to do this, we will need the data set, and in order to ensure that the histogram that is generated by the TI graphing calculator matches the one that we constructed by hand, we will need the class boundaries and the class width that we found in the process of constructing the grouped frequency distribution. We should begin by pressing STAT and then 1 and then entering the data into a list. Here the data have been entered into list 1. Then press Y equals and make sure that all functions entered there are turned off. They can be turned off using the cursor to highlight the equals sign and then pressing Enter. Note that the equals sign is no longer highlighted. This indicates that this function is turned off and will not be graphed. Note that the second function of the Y equals button is statplot. This calculator function allows us to create graphical displays of data such as a histogram. So press second, statplot. Let's access the first statplot by pressing 1. We should begin by turning this plot on. Make sure that the cursor is blinking on the on selection and press Enter. Cursor down and then over until the histogram icon is highlighted and press Enter. Cursor down and make sure that the correct list is specified. Our data are in list 1. Now press the graph button. Note that the display looks nothing like the histogram that we created by hand. It is also apparent that the entire histogram is not displayed and appears to be cut off on the right. We need to set our window so that the entire histogram is displayed correctly. So press Window. Our X minimum value should be the lower bound of the first class. That is 2.5. Cursor down to the maximum line. This should be set so that the upper bound for the last class appears on the screen. The upper bound for the last class was 58.5. We will set the maximum value to 60 so that the entire histogram appears on the screen. Cursor down to scale and enter the class width from the grouped frequency distribution. The width was 8. Now cursor down to the minimum Y value and set that to 0. Cursor down to the Y maximum value and make sure that the value is greater than the largest frequency in the grouped frequency distribution. The largest frequency in this grouped frequency distribution appears in the first class and is 34. We will set the maximum Y value to 40, again to ensure that the entire histogram appears on the screen. Now press Graph. This histogram now matches the one that we constructed by hand. The calculator will display the lower and upper bounds and frequencies for each class by pressing Trace. Note now that the minimum and maximum values for the first class are 2.5 and 10.5 respectively. Note also that the frequency is given as 34. Press the right cursor to advance to the next class in the histogram. Again, the lower and upper bounds and frequency for that class are displayed. In this video, we learned how to construct a histogram using the TI graphing calculator.